Hey guys, it's BeatUpLater95 here, giving you the first review for my YouTube channel and for this particular beat-em-on. This is number 32 in the Assault and the Crash beat-em-on line. It is Assault Taurus, a 67 caliber control type. So we're going to go around the box real quick, and this is the user right here. I don't know his name, I never read the manga or watched the anime, so your guess is probably just as good as mine is. It is an authentic Takara Tommy beat-em-on. On this side right here, it has a stat table. I'm assuming this is the stats because there's the star ranking there. Now, before we move on, I just want to say I'm filming from my cell phone, so it might fade out. I'm going to try to fix this every once in a while when it gets bad. So, on number one for the stats, it has 2 out of 3 stars. I'm going to assume that's for the grip, for power. And for number 2, it shows the 67 caliber barrel, and it has 3 control and 2 power. And the beat-em-on itself is number 3, and your guess is better than mine is on that. It is synchro weapon system, though, just for the record. On the back of the box, it shows on the top left corner the switch barrel gimmick, and we will get to that in a little bit. It shows the sniper or better control mode. I don't really know how to say it. It has a sight it makes, and we'll demonstrate how that works. How to hold the beat-em-on with the the magazine clip piece held on. The 3 main pieces: the barrel, the beat-em-on, and the grip. How to fire the beat-em-on by itself, with the synchro weapon, and any crash battle recommendation against Justice Ifrit, although we know Ifrit is probably the better of these two. On the other side of the box, it is this crazy combo, and this is the main reason why I do love the crash line so much, is because these combos you can make. This combo actually right here is based off a mock Garuda, and 3 synchro weapons. Now, I can't really tell, you know, if I'll make one of these in the future. These are not easy to come across because the series was canceled in Japan, because these do look like guns. So, these toys are pretty hard to come across, and Sonokong has not made another release like they have with the Fire Spirit Speedemons. These are harder to come across, so they do cost a ton. This actually costs $30 to buy. And that was without the terrible shipping. So, box aside, let's go to the beat-em-on. So, the beat-em-on itself is pretty nice. It's my first Crash series beat-em-on, so I'm still kind of getting used to the feel. I've only literally owned it for 32 hours. Wow, so I barely made that deadline of 36 hours. So, the beat-em-on itself, this is what it looks like in its standard kind of mode, and I will review each individual piece. So let me take this apart real quick, and I will get to you in 1 second. So, welcome back. Here are the pieces, all separated, obviously. We're going to go with the barrel down to the grip. So, with the barrel itself, this is probably why the Crash Beat-em-on series is probably one of my favorites. Let me fade back in real quick. I'm falling. There we go. So the barrel itself is very flush with a marble. If I can try to get this on camera. Okay, it's not going to show. There we go. There's literally like no bounce in here. So the marble will actually go straight through, and it's basically like an extended core and not like the grip barrels or covert barrels from the CrossFight line. Now, the barrel's main gimmick is obviously the barrel break in front. That's what these are referred to in shooting language. It's a muzzle or a barrel break. So on this form right here, as you can see, you have 2 rollers down, and they sound actually pretty nice. I don't have a problem with that. Now, to change to the sniper mode, or I don't know, better control mode, I want to call it, you push the barrel up and kind of spin it around to clicks, and now you have a stabilizer for the front and a sight for the opposite side. Now, to to the Beat-em-on itself, it's plain. I mean, there's nothing really special besides this gargantuan horn that does bend all the way back to reveal the head if you, like, your Beat-em-on, well, like that. It's Taurus, so the horn is kind of an obvious gimmick. Now it's the grip. The grip, I'm gonna do a separate review on this grip after this, because I hate this grip. It is terrible. It's a two-handed grip, so you can fire it with your right hand, and if you're left-handed, you can do the same thing. Now, it does have the adapter for a synchro weapon right here, and just a latch on your Beat-em-on, and a latch for the magazine. Nothing really major. So, let me put this all together real quick, and I will get back to you again. Alright, and here we are put back together again. This is in the sniper, or barrel, or whatever you want to call it kind of mode. I'm going to fire it off at a cartridge real quickly. Let me add two more marbles into there for us. And let's see if I can hit that little cartridge. Okay, well, first shot. That was actually better than I had expected. So, these Beat-em-on are, just for the record, these are quite powerful. I'm on a king-size mattress. That's about 9, maybe 10 foot. And this can go from the very edge to, yeah, almost all the way across the bed. These are pretty powerful Beat-em-on, so keep that in mind. They are all power types, actually. So, the Beat-em-on itself, it's pretty nice. It's a big Beat-em-on. I mean, that's at least, I would guess, about 9 inches from where the horn has stopped, and then a few more to add the grip into it. Now, the Beat-em-on, it feels pretty good. The trigger system is a bit iffy. It has a really strong spring into it, but it sounds, let's see if you can hear it. It's like a very tight gear system, so it's not any better than just putting the horn up and shooting from the back if you want to have that old school feeling. Now, the Beat-em-on, like I said, this is cool. It's a cool Beat-em-on. There's nothing really special to break about it. I mean, it's a crash Beat-em-on, and these are obviously quite the important part of the Beat-em-on history, because it's the first series so far that's been banned in Japan, and that's why we never got these in the U.S. Or you could blame the fact that, well, they never really kicked off in the U.S. either. You never see a Cobalt Saber fire from Hasbro, so there's always that right there. Now, you can switch the barrel back up, and this is kind of like the muzzle brake again. Pop it back up, and now you have the rollers down. You really can't use the horn as much, because now your sight is gone. But it works equally. That's actually a better sight than I thought it was. So, yeah, that's my review. I mean, there's not much to say about it. Like, if I could read the back of this box, it would probably be a 10-minute review. But, I will do some follow-up reviews. If you liked this or you want to see more Beat-em-on reviews, hit the like button below and also subscribe, because once we hit 50 subscribers, I will do a small giveaway. And once we hit 1,000 subscribers, I will do an incredible giveaway. But let's start with 50. We'll move our way up, guys. So this is BeatAblader95 signing off.